You are listening to the broadcast from beyond. This is Mysterious Journeys and True Life Stories. Good evening, friends and journey seekers alike. We are so pleased to have you aboard our vessel of travel tonight as we traverse the universe beyond the stars for the truth. Won't you join us? And now, here is your host, Michael Hart. And a good evening to you, and it's warm out there. Yes, it's hot. Good old summer. I particularly don't care for it at all. I've never liked the summer, ever. It's just too sticky and unbearable. There's no, there's no good place to go on a day like today. And it's going to get hotter this weekend. I think reaching up into the hundreds, I think, Saturday and Sunday. Yeah, it's going to be a hot one. Well, tonight we've got some pretty interesting stories for you to start things off. I have some stories here that are quite interesting. Ghost stories, mainly, for the most part. Little short ones. Tidbits of information that are just come across my search. Quite different, you know, from the stories that I normally tell. Also, coming up tonight, we have trumpet sounds. That's right, trumpet sounds from around the world. And we'll be talking about that tonight. Let's get into what we have here. This one is from redbookmag.com. The first story, well, it's a short one, most of them are, shows a picture of a family in the water, in a lake water, I guess you could say that. It looks almost like a pond. Looking at this, I think that it's more like a, probably a lake. I'm not sure. And it doesn't say in the story. Family photobombed and harassed by ghosts of girl who drowned in the river. Yeah, it's safe to say we are sticking to pools from now on. After spending an afternoon splashing in a watering hole in Queensland, Australia, it's a watering hole, so I guess that would be equivalent of a small pond or something to that nature. Kim Davidson was shocked when she looked back at photos to find a girl who hadn't been swimming that day. In the picture is which, it shows a picture of this supposed apparition. Davidson consulted paranormal experts who determined that the mystery child is Doreen O'Sullivan, who drowned in that very spot over 100 years ago in 1913. Looking at the picture, I can see what looks like it looks like a little girl. It's hard to make out what she looked like, there's four children, and the mother is giving a hand signal, I guess. She's holding a baby, and right beside her, almost behind her, is this supposed apparition or child that had drowned there that many years ago, back in 1913. Very strange. Another one is also concerning a ghost. A figure wanders around Hampton Court Place, or Palace, excuse me. The Hampton Court Palace is supposedly known for restless spirit visits and spottings, but none compared to this photo of the Queen's private chamber. It's hard to tell at first glance, but if you look very carefully, there appears to be a silhouette
of a child in a Tudor white nursery gown, roaming near one of the dresses on display. A spokesman from the Royal Building believes this is one of the two children who drowned in a nearby lake that has haunted the grounds for many years, another drowning. And I'm trying to get a good view of this thing. I'm trying to zoom in. So, yeah, I mean, it kind of looks like looks almost like reflection on the floor. And it's in between these dress displays, which are, I guess they're up on some sort of stands or something that keep them in a pose. And there's nobody in the dresses, of course. It's just a display. And you can see what appears to be a ghost there. Another one, but this one is an evil spirit. The headline reads, "An evil spirit attacks reporter during a live segment on CNN. Don't believe in ghosts? We bet these two CNN reporters do after they visited a haunted house in Pennsylvania last summer. While filming a segment in the super scary home, one photojournalist says he was scratched on the wrist while a reporter claims an evil spirit pinched and touched her. According to Movie Pilot, the video report also caught the sound of a spirit saying, "Come here." An image of the demon's hand near the stairs and a tall, shadowy figure pictured above lurking in the basement. Yeah, good luck sleeping tonight. And it shows a photo. The photo is kind of an amber sort of color, I guess, to some extent, up on the ceiling and against the wall. I'm assuming that what we're seeing here in this picture of this shadow figure is our ghost. Another ghost story. Little girl pushed over by a ghost. Filming their daughter, Lexi, became strange really fast when Gareth and Charlene Hood caught some kind of apparition pushing their daughter over, causing her to fly backward. After the home video was posted to YouTube, the internet got in a heated debate over whether the child, or the toddler rather, simply fell over or was actually pushed to the ground. Ghost or no ghost, we can all be happy that little Lexi wasn't harmed in the abnormal incident. And there's really nothing there. I mean, it's a photo of the child. And it looks like maybe near a window or something. I thought that was a TV at first. Maybe it is. I'm not sure. But that's all you really get to see in that kind of a sort of blurred image of a photo there. Here's an interesting little piece that I thought was really kind of strange. I read this earlier. Shocking photo, a possessed girl found in toy princess wand. Yeah. When Nicole Allen tried to buy her daughter a princess wand present last November, she discovered something extremely disturbing. A foil piece on the top of the wand fell off after being opened and revealed a photo of a possessed child cutting her wrists underneath. What's even more horrifying, yes, it really does get worse, is that the store owner reportedly told Allen that she should have known what she was purchasing from the toy's name, Evil Stick, and that he would only take the toy off the shelves if he received more complaints. No word yet on whether those complaints have come in or if the store owner really cares. Well, that's strange. Really, that's crazy. And anyway, there's some odd and unusual people out there. I can't believe they put that in a store. And those are our ghost stories. Well, most of them were ghost stories. Was unintentional for me to read those, but they were mostly all spiritually related. So Well, what do we have for you tonight is we have audio of what I would call sky trumpets. And we'll get into that after the break. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. This is Mysterious Journeys and True Life Stories. You are listening to the broadcast from beyond. This is Mysterious Journeys and True Life Stories. Everyone likes free stuff. I know I do. There are two things I like to hear that comes with the word free. Free music and royalty free music. That's right. Now that's having your cake and eating it too. That's why I want to take the time to tell you about an offer you can't refuse. If you're a podcaster, filmmaker, or YouTube video creator looking for great sounding background music, soundtracks, or bumper music, then Royalty Free Planet is the place for you. They have hundreds of artists and genres to choose from, with categories ranging from hip-hop, trap, dubstep, to modern dance tracks, rock, and even 80s-style synthscapes. It's what I use as bumper tracks for my show, and if you're a podcaster, you'll love the high-quality sound of these talented artists who have worked hard to bring us their music, and offer a copyright-free advantage to make your project sound great. Just remember to give these artists the credit by listing the name of the artist and song title. It's the least we could do in return for their hard-earned efforts to bring you pro sounds at no cost or copyright cost to you. So check out their YouTube channel and listen to the variety of excellent selections they offer at Royalty Free Planet. That's Royalty Free Planet. You'll be glad you did, and they will too. Trumpet sounds we're going to play for you. We're going to give it a listen. And I'm going to tell you something. The Bible, we are coming up on some very strange times. I mean, it doesn't take a rocket scientist to look around and see that something quite unusual and supernatural is going on this planet. And I hope and pray that people are in the right with God. Anyway, let's give this a listen.
Here it is. Heard in the atmosphere. People around the world and here at home have reported hearing some bizarre noises.
Some strange noises heard around the world the last few weeks has people buzzing, especially on YouTube. Clips posted from Arizona to England and right next door in Manitoba, all showing folks alarmed by what sounds like a noise straight out of a science fiction flick.
They've happened here and across the country. Mysterious booming noises that, for the most part, have gone unexplained. No one seems to know what is causing these weird booms. Not police, not scientists, not even the military.
And there's the sound. And I think back to the guy who, the video I played before, trying to explain that, you know, it's just something in the cosmos. I don't think so. And these are, videos. We're playing audio from videos that, people have recorded. Here's another one. These are all different clips. That sounds extremely loud. I'm going to tell you, the time this was going on, which was some years ago, I had talked to my parents and they heard something very strange. It was, at night they had come home from somewhere. I don't remember exactly where they had driven in from, but they said it was an eerie sound and an eerie feeling. It was cold, and the wind was blowing, and they could hear something like what you're hearing here. I talked to my my mother about this, and she confirmed that that's what they had heard. And they live in Elberton, Georgia. And, you know, I myself one night had heard something coming from the... I want to say it was more closer to the I-20 road or overpass of going across a bridge or somewhere in that vicinity. And we live in North Augusta, so it's basically up on kind of a hill. So you kind of catch things. Sounds come up in a way. They come over the land, and this was in the evening or at night. I don't remember exactly what time it was, but I remember hearing some very awkward and strange sounds coming from one particular direction, and it sounded similar to some of these things that people are catching on their video cameras or caught in their video cameras. Let's go on with the tape.
Thank you.
That's loud. Here's another one. That sounds like, that sounds very eerie. It's the video I'm looking at now has,
you guys hear that?
These people are standing outside listening to it. This is in Russia, I believe. That's that was the video there, but it sounds like an orchestra tuning up to play. It doesn't sound like you know, they're actually playing a note, but it sounds like they're tuning up instruments to play. It's very odd. I know the one that I was talking about earlier that I'd heard here, I don't remember the exact sound, but it was kind of a distance. It was a good distance, and you could clearly hear it. And it would sort of fade in, fade out, fade in, fade out. And it kind of had a deeper sound. So, if these can't be explained by any kind of rationality, which I find it very hard for anyone to explain this, since it happened all over the world. I mean, it wasn't just in America or China or Russia. It was everywhere, happening in intervals at different times. And if you hear them all played together, it sounds exactly like a band or an orchestra tuning up to play. It's very strange, and it makes me wonder, is God giving us a warning? I would say, given the times that we're living in and the things going on around us, boy, it sure makes sense to me. I'd say yes. It's enough to make you get on your knees and pray to God that you have to go through anything horrible in the distant future, if you're still around to see it or experience it. But what exactly is it that we're hearing? I've seen other videos, and people have said some things that were a bit interesting, but it just didn't really strike me as this, the course of, it didn't stay in the course of realism. Because if you read the Bible, and I know I have many times, especially Revelations, since it hasn't happened yet, you'll see that time could be drawing nigh rather quick. Maybe not quick to God, because his time is not our time. No, it is not. So, that's the way I see it, and that's the way I heard it. We'll be right back after this message This is Mysterious Journeys and True Life Stories. Don't go anywhere.
Seen a ghost or an apparition, or perhaps your house might be haunted? Or have you ever looked up into the sky at night and seen lights defying the laws of physics? If you have, I would encourage you to send your stories to me, and I will read them on the air with your consent. Send your stories to oculusmusic@gmail.com. That's oculusmusic@gmail.com. O-C-U-L-I-S, music, one word, @gmail.com. I'll be looking forward to your stories.
You are listening to the broadcast from beyond. This is Mysterious Journeys and True Life Stories.
When we're talking about trumpet sounds heard in the sky, very unusual, very disturbing to those who do not understand where they come from or biblical prophecy. And I guess that's what I'm saying when I say where they come from. We have some more here I would love for you to hear. And this one. This one is coming from a neighborhood. It sounds like in Europe somewhere. That was, I believe that was probably France or someplace like that. I'm not sure. It's weird. And a lot of this stuff is... I think it's all biblically related. Now, the question is God giving us a chance to redeem ourselves by doing this? If it's truly Him? And if not, are we entering into a phase of the part of the Bible and Revelations where there's basically no turning back? Apparently, I mean, you know, we don't just get to turn back time. Obviously, it's not what I mean. But I think it's to show us, warn us of man's error of evil ways. I call it redemption. So, we have another clip here to play for you, and this one's in the Philippines in Sarala.
Let me warn everyone that the following clip may be disturbing to some viewers. Here's the video.
disturbing to who? I guess to those who don't understand or believe. To non-believers. Yeah. Good grief.
Local weather stations and meteorologists speculate that this unusual event is highly related to the snowfall that's also reported in the Philippines last month. Christina Tomlinson, CF News.
Well, you know, I don't know. You know, that they say, you know, it can be explained. We got the answer right here, and it's disturbing to everyone. No, I don't think that it should be, what, to those who do not believe or do not understand because of lack of knowledge? Of course. Of course it would be something they would not understand. And then, you know, therefore, henceforth, you know, no one would get that. And they would be, I guess, scared of whatever. Are they thinking aliens, possibly, or who knows? But what is it? Well, I can't rightly say that I know. I'm not an expert. But given what those of us who have read the Bible understand, that they are not mysteries, but they are fact. They just haven't happened yet. I think it's fair to say that what we're hearing here could very well be. I wouldn't jump the gun too much, but say this is the final stages of what's in the book of Revelations, and I'm talking about the end of the era as we know it.
You have been listening to the broadcast from beyond. This is Mysterious Journeys and True Life Stories. Good night. We'll be right back.
We'll be right back.